Hi everyone, my name is Daniel Laskwitz, and today I'm gonna show you how cool it is to work with functions in Win Automation. Win Automation is a tool that is part of Softomotive, and Softomotive is a company that got acquired by Microsoft last week. Microsoft announced it during build, and I have been digging around in the tool. And I already found some really cool things like functions. And today I'm going to tell you about that. So without further ado, let's just dive into my desktop and show you how it works. Here we are in the Win Automation Console. Win Automation Console is the app you get when you install the Win Automation software. It has a couple of examples. I already talked about that in an earlier video. I'll put the link in the description as well if you want to see that. And I also have a demo folder in my processes. I have two processes in here. I have demo invoicing app normal and demo invoicing with functions. So let's select the first one. And let me show you what this does. This demo invoicing app normal process, it retrieves files in the folder, and that's my OneDrive and the data folder. So whenever I open up my file explorer, I can go to my OneDrive, to data, and then I'll see the invoicing XLSX. So there's only one file in that folder. After that, there's a for each loop, and the for each loop loops through the variable files, and the variable files, that's what has been stored after the get files in folder action. And that means that it got all the files and it put it in a variable, and now the for each loop is looping through that variable. So if there's one file, it will only show the one file, but if there's 10, they we'll add the 10 to the files variable. And after that, when it's looping, it will store the current item. So if it's 10, then they start with the first one. It will store that current item into current file. That's another variable I created. After that, it launches Excel and it uses the current file.filename variable. And that's the file that is one of the files in the folder, of course. After that, it sets the active Excel worksheet. So it sets it to accounts. It gets the first three row on column from Excel worksheet. So it looks at the whole worksheet, and in the accounts worksheet, it looks for the first empty row and it gets that one. So if you have 10 items in there, and you have maybe a header rule, then you would have the 11th or the 12th row will be empty. And the 12th row will of course be returned when you get that. Then it will read from the Excel worksheet, and it will read the values from the cells ranging from column 1, row 1, so at the left top corner, to column 3, so 2 to the side, and row, and then you get a variable, first free row on column minus 1. So it gets the 12th row if we have 10 items in there, and it gets one less. So it makes sure that all the content is there, but not the first free row. And then it stores all that data into accounts data, which is another variable I created. After that, it starts an application, a legacy invoicing application. I can open that right now. So this is the application it will start. And this application has some capabilities. I'll show them a little bit later. So after it runs the application, we'll go through another for each loop. And that for each loop will iterate through the account data. And that's the output of the read from Excel worksheet action. After that, it will wait for the window to open because it needs to make sure that the window is open. Contoso invoicing. After that, it will click on an element in the window, and that's the label accounts. And I already created that before. So if you see it here, you have the accounts here, and this is a label, and I select that one. After that, it will click on the control button new. So that's this button. After that, it will input an account name in here. So that's account name. Primary contact. So it will put a primary contact in here and it will get a contact email. So contact at email.com. And when it's done with that, it will at the end, it will save it as well. So here is the save button and it will save it. And then the account has been added. After that, it will close the window. When maybe there's two people in there, one people, it will just loop through one or maybe two times. It depends on how much rows you have in your Excel file. After that, it will close the window of the Contoso invoicing app. It will set the active Excel worksheet to invoices. And that's another one I have in that Excel. And then it gets the free row again. It will read from Excel worksheet. So it will, of course, read all the values. It will start again from the top left corner. So column one, row one, and then it will go to column five. So there's more data in there. At the first one, there were only three rows or three columns. And now it's actually five columns in here. And the row is going to be the invoice first free row on column minus one again. So the same as the earlier action to make sure that we only get the content that's in there and not the first empty row. After that, it starts the legacy invoicing app again. It will go through a for each loop again with all the data that I stored into the invoices data variable, and it will store the current item into current invoices row. After that, it will wait for the window again, so to make sure that Contoso invoicing is loaded. After that, it will do some other stuff, and I'm going to show you what it does actually. So the first thing is it will click on the control label invoices. So here is the label invoices. It will click on the button new. So that's this one. It will select the input date, and that's this one. It will put control A in there. So it will select the whole thing and it will insert another date. So that could be 5/24/2020, for instance. After that, it will click on the account. So we can use company name, for instance. After that, it will select the contact. You can see that here. So contact, and it will insert the contact. Primary contact in this case. And it will enter also the amount. So it will put the amount in there, and I'm going to put 5,000 in there. And it will also set the drop-down list value in window, and it will get the status drop-down, and it will set that to something different. So for instance, invoiced. And then at the end, it will save the invoice again. So that's what it will do. After that, it will end the loop. It will close the window of the legacy application. It will close Excel as well, because that was still open. And then it will end the complete loop of all the files that I had. So the files in folder, and that's it. So that's the whole process. And if I would, for instance, start this process, I can click on the start button or press F10. And when I do this, I can just select it and it will go through the whole process. So it opens Contoso Invoicing. It already had Excel in the taskbar, but it didn't focus on that. So here it goes. It's adding Satya Nadella as a contact from Microsoft. And then it opens the app again. It will go to invoices. And when it's going to invoices, it will create a new one. It will enter some data, 50,000, and it will stop the whole thing. And when I now open the Contoso Invoicing app, you can see that there has been a Microsoft invoice, or sorry, an account in here. And when I go to invoices, there is a Microsoft account in here that has been invoiced $50,000. And to prove you that this works, I open the data directory, open up the invoicing Excel file. Oh, hold on. And you can see that I have the data in here. So this is the invoice. And when I go to accounts, you can see that I have Satya Nadella, Satya at Microsoft.com, and company is Microsoft. So that's what this completely does. But if you look at the script, you can see that it has a lot of actions. It has 50 actions for a pretty short script, actually. And it finishes really fast. So what if I want to change this? So I might want to incorporate all the different actions in a certain for each loop and use that as a function. I already created a script for that, but let me show you how that will look then. So here is my demo invoicing app with functions process. And then you can see I have lots less. I have 29 instead of 50. So that's more than 20 less steps. So it's a way better overview of what you have here. And of course, I also documented this process. So I have some comments in here. If I would remove those, I would have even less steps in here. But if you look at this whole thing, it will go into a for each loop, it will launch Excel, it will run the application, the legacy application. But in the for each loop, it will just run a function called create account. And if you scroll down even more, you can see that the run function create invoice is there. And that's to make it even smaller. So when I open up the next tab here, you can see that I have a create account function here. And there's multiple steps in here. That's all the steps I need to input data into the legacy application. So that's 10 steps and it goes through that here. And the other one is create an invoice. And when I create an invoice, I can see that there's also 13 steps in here. And you can see those in here as well. And how does that work actually? How can you create the functions? Let me switch to the other script I already showed you and how that works. So what we easily can do is we can go stand on the comment here. We can go and create a new function. So let's select that one on the top right side. I can select create account. And now there's an empty pane where I can drop some actions in. But for now, I'm going to do it differently. I'm going to select all the actions that are in the loop, except the comment, because I don't want to have the comment in there. I'm going to cut all the actions. I'm going to go to the create account function, and I'm going to paste the actions there. Then I move to the main part again. And now, of course, I want to run a function. So I'm going to search in the actions for function. And then you can see I have a run function action here. I can put that in here. I can just leave it blank because the, or at least I can leave it as is, because the create account function is already there. Select OK, and that's it for this function. Now I want to have, of course, the create invoice action or function. So let's do that as well. Create invoice. And then I have a blank canvas again. I can go to main. I can select all the actions I want to cut from here. And I use also my keyboard. So Control plus X works as well. Control plus V. And then it's all done. I only have to run the function from here and select the right one. So when I do that, here it is. And those are the steps that we need in here. Let's change this around a little bit. Let's use a different person. I'm gonna use my own CEO. So Joost Raammakers. Joost@society.nl. And I'm not using the real email addresses here. I'm gonna send him an invoice. So let's use the account societyjoost@society.com or sorry, .nl. Let's do .com. Sorry, that's a one. I will choose an amount, and that's gonna be, let's keep it simple, 5,000. And I'm gonna use invoiced. So let me just check. Oh, I had the .nl here. Let's change it to .com. So it's all the same. I'm already saving it because it's on my OneDrive, so it automatically saves because of the handy autosave function. I can close this one down and then I can start the process again. So let me first take a look here. You can see that Microsoft is the last invoice. And when you go to accounts, you can also see that Satya Nadella is the last one at 1007. So I'm going to close this one down. I'm gonna hit play again, and now you can see that the workflow is running. Here it goes. Okay, and there it is. So it went through the whole step-by-step thing. And if I open up my Contoso invoicing app, you can see that Society is the next one. Joost Raammakers is 1008. And if you go to invoices, you can see that there's also $5,000 been invoiced to Joost. And that's how easy it is to convert your process, your normal process, to a process with functions. With that, we are at the end of the video. Thanks a lot for watching. I hope you really liked it. If you have some suggestions or other things you want to see, please leave it below in the reactions and the comments, and please like and subscribe, and I'll see you at the next video.